get to the point.
These Occupy Wall Street leftists, they're goading the police into violence. They are confronting the police so they can get more attention for their left-wing cause of ending capitalism and going after the rich, the job creators in our country. These Occupy Wall Street leftists, they're goading the police. These Occupy Wall Street leftists, they're goading the police. These Occupy Wall Street leftists, they're goading the police, goading the police, goading the police, goading the police. These Occupy Wall Street leftists, they're goading the police. These Occupy Wall Street leftists, they're goading the police, goading the police, goading the police.
Get back. You guys get back.
Move.
We're here. We're here. It's chill.
Stop that!
These Occupy Wall Street leftists, they're goading the police into violence. They are confronting the police so they can get more attention for their left-wing cause of ending capitalism and going after the rich, the job creators in our country.
Is this okay? Is this okay?
And that clip shows that this extremists are drawn to this movement. If you look at Doug Schoen's study, he put together a study where he sent some people down to poll these Wall Street demonstrators. Most of them are professional protesters, and a third of them advocate violence.
The situation in Oakland much calmer last night than it was on Tuesday, when demonstrators faced cops in riot gear and lots of tear gas. Officers clearing the plaza outside City Hall, police pelted with rocks, bottles, and other objects, arresting about 100 in the crowd. Last night, protesters returned to City Hall but didn't try to stay overnight, filing out and marching through nearby streets with cops looking on. One demonstrator, an Iraq war veteran, suffered a fractured skull in Tuesday's skirmishes. Scott Olson, a 24-year-old Marine, is in critical condition. It's not clear how he was hit or who might have done it. It's not clear how he was hit or who might have done it. It's not clear how he was hit or who might have done it. It's not clear how he was hit or who might have done it. It's not clear how he was hit or who might have done it. Although Oakland's top cop says they're investigating the events leading to Olson's injury as vigorously as they would a fatal police shooting.
Didn't you read the New Yorker magazine piece where they took the survey? Didn't you see Doug Schoen's poll that says 30% of the occupiers will use violence to get what they want? Come on, that's the data.